Hello everyone. We have already seen some of the concepts related to the binary search tree. For example, we have discussed about how to create the binary tree from the keys. We have seen what is the process of the insertion in the binary search tree. In today's lecture, we will see how to find the successor and the predecessors in the binary search tree. Now, before going for finding out the successor and the predecessor, we need to have a concept of finding the minimum and the maximum from the binary search tree. So the minimum means what is the key containing the minimum information. We need to find out the address of that node. So the process that we have to define is the BST minimum, wherein the address of root node is given, and we have to find out the node that contains the information which is minimum in the tree. So it is quite clear that the minimum information can be found in the left subtree, and the leftmost information in the binary search tree will be the target information. So let's say P is given as a root node, and then if we have to find out the minimum information, then we will have to find that towards the left. So if we do the leftmost traversal in the binary search tree, we will find the node containing the minimum information. So we can also say that the extreme left element in the binary search tree will be the minimum element. Now, how to find this minimum element? You will have to start your traversal from the root. If the current node, if the given node, or if the given current node has a left child, you will move towards the left. And then for this particular tree, P is at 20 now. It also has a left child, so you will move to the left. And 10 also has a left child, so you will move to the left. And 5 also has a left child, so you will move to the left. But 1 now does not have a left child. So obviously this node is the extreme left element, and this will be containing the minimum information. So you have to traverse to the left nodes. So what we are saying that we are taking a P, that is a temporary pointer for the leftmost traversal, and I'm taking this P equal to the T. It means P is taking the address of the root node. So I can say that while P dot left is not null, we are doing the traversal. So P is equals to P dot left. The moment we find that P dot left is null, I'll escape out of this loop and will return P, and P will be the address of the node containing the minimum information. So this is pretty straightforward operation, the BST minimum. Similarly, we can design the BST maximum operation also, and the maximum operation of the BST will be of finding the rightmost node. This also is very obvious. The greater information can be found towards the right subtree, and the rightmost element in the binary search tree will be containing the greatest information. So if we start our traversal from the root node, this has a right child, so move to the right. This also has a right child, so the right. This also has a right child, so move to the right. This 48 also has a right child, so move to the right. And now this 50 does not have a right child, so 50 is the target information, and this actually is the largest information in this tree. So let's start with rightmost traversal by taking P at the root node, and then while P dot right is not equal to null, you keep traversing towards the right. So P is equals to P dot right. The moment you terminate this loop, or the moment this loop is terminated, meaning that I have reached to the node containing the maximum information, then you will return the address of that node. So this is the BST maximum algorithm. Now for finding the successor in a binary search tree, these two, means minimum and the maximum, or either of these two, will help us in finding that. For example, in our given tree, let's say the node which is given to us is this P that contains information 36. So successor means the immediate higher information in the binary search tree. Immediate higher means out of all the nodes after 36, the immediate higher information, larger information, is 38. So this information or this node can be found with the help of the in-order traversal also. So in case you do the in order traversal of the tree and you find out 36 and you find out 38, or if you find out 36 and then the immediate next information to 36 will be 38 and that will be your target. But the in-order traversal will require order of n time, but we are not interested in spending that much time. We can do this in the order of log n time also. One more thing is that in the in-order traversal, we are finding the node data value, but we are interested in the address of the address of the node that contains immediate hash information. So for doing so, if you consider this node 36 or the node P which contains the information 36, if you go to the right of this node P and find out the minimum information, so obviously the minimum of the right subtree, that is 38, will be the immediate higher information than this 36. So 38 will be the successor. So minimum of right subtree will be the successor. Let's take another example to understand this. Let's say the successor, the node that for which we have to find out the successor is this 10. So for this 10, the right subtree is this one. Out of this right subtree, the minimum information will be this 12 only. This is the leftmost. So 12 will be the successor of this P. And now let's say we have to find out the successor of node, let's say 40. So for 40, the immediate hash information will be towards the right. And towards the right, the leftmost element is 45. So 45 will be the successor of given node 40. So this way we can find out the successors. So minimum of the right will be the successor. Although this is not complete, we will have to write the complete algorithm. But for the moment, we can write this like this, that we have to find out the BST successor. And in this BST successor, a node is given with the address P. So what I'm saying that if the right of P exists, if the right child of or the right subtree of P exists, so if P dot right is not null, then if we move to the right, we can find out the minimum information. So we just have to go to call the function BST minimum of p dot right. Whatever this returns, let's say that is q, and this will be the successor of the given node. Now there may be the cases wherein the successor or the right of the given node does not exist. For example, if we have to find out the successor of node 15. So for this 15, the right child does not exist. The right subtree does not exist. So this condition will fail. So I will have to come to the else. Let's see what can be written in the else. The right subtree does not exist, but that does not mean that 15 does not have a successor. So for finding out the successor, you can expect the successor of this P in the upper level nodes or towards the parent. So let's say Q is the parent of P. Okay. Till now, whenever we have implemented the binary search tree, we have assumed that, or when we have implemented the binary tree, we have assumed that we only have three fields. So we had the data, and then we have the left child and the right child field. But here we are assuming that we have a father field also, because the father field will help me to go up. So Q is the father of P. And in case P is the right child of Q, if P is the right child of its father, then the information of father will be smaller and the information of P will be larger. So obviously Q cannot be the successor. So you move one step ahead or one step up. You bring P where Q is and you move Q to one step further for to its parent. You once again find if P is the right child of its father. If P is the right child of his father, it means P will have larger information and the father will have less information. So you are actually searching for the larger information, not the smaller one. So you are moving one step ahead again. So P is here and Q is here and P is the left child of the father. So if P is the left child of the father, it means P will have smaller information and Q will have larger information. And this Q will be the successor. Why this Q will be successor? Because towards the upper level nodes, you will find larger information. Towards the right subtree of Q, you will also find the larger information. So only this node Q will have the smallest information, which is larger than the 15. Fine. So to actually write this algorithm, or before writing this algorithm, let's take one more example. Let's say we have the node 22 and we have to find out the successor of this 22. So let's say its father at P. So now P is the right child of its father. So you move one step ahead. So P is here and Q is here. Now P is not the right child of the father. So now Q is the node, which is the target node. We can say that this Q is the successor of the given node P. Obviously, 25 will be the successor of 22. Let's take one more example. Let's say we have to find out the successor of this node 28, which does not have a right child. So we will have to go up. So let's take Q as the father of P. So now Q has a left child P, or you can say that P is the left child of the father. It is not the right child. So obviously the father will have more information than the P. So hence Q will be the successor. So let's write this in the form of the algorithm. So we are actually saying that the Q is the father of P, or P dot father. What I'm checking is if the right child of Q is P, then I have to move up. So while moving up, P is brought to the position where Q was, and Q is brought to its father. Now, once again, we have to check this condition, whether Q dot write is equals to P or not. So that means instead of writing if, we have to keep this in the loop. So we have to repeatedly check this. So while Q dot father is equals to P, we have to do this. And once this condition fails, when this loop ends, we can return P, and this P will be the target node, or not, the Q will be, we will have to return this Q. Q will be the target node for returning. Q will be the successor of the given node P. For finishing this algorithm, I will have to take one more condition. Let's say P is this node, and we have to find out the successor of this node. For this node P, 50, which is the largest information in this node, will not have any successor. So how can we conclude that it does not have any successor? Let's take its father. He is the right child of the father, so move up. P again is the right child of the father, move up. P again is the right child of the father, move up. P again is the right child of the father, so move up. As you move up, Q does not have a right child, does not have a father, so Q becomes null. The moment Q becomes null, I will have to say that P successor of P does not exist. Or in this algorithm, if you return Q as a null, that will be an indication that the successor of the given node does not exist. So let us accommodate this somewhere in this algorithm. I'm actually including one more condition here in this loop. So I'm saying that Q is not null, then only check this condition. Obviously, we will have to check this condition only if Q is not null. So if Q is not null and Q dot right is equals to P, then P is equals to Q and Q equals to Q dot father. But if this condition fails, then you have to return. Just a minute. I'm letting this refresh. Now once this loop finishes, you have to return Q. In case Q has become null, you will return Q. This was the case where Q was becoming null. So I'm returning null, which is an indicator that the left child, the successor does not exist. Right? You need to keep this else at the right place. so that this entire thing looks inside there. And this if will also be get here. So if p.write is not null, do this. And if p.write is null, do this. So this was the additional condition that we have included. In case this will handle the case where we have reached to the root node and the father of the root node is not existing. And obviously, if we are searching for the successor and q has become null, so successor will not be there. So by returning the q, if a q is a valid address, it means the successor has been found. If q is null, it means the successor does not exist. So this is the algorithm for BST successor. Now, as we have made the algorithm for the successor, in a just a similar way, we can write out this algorithm for the predecessor also. Predecessor means you have to find out the immediate less information, yeah, immediate smaller information than the current node. For example, if I'm searching for the predecessor of this p node, so this 20 will be the immediate smaller information. If I'm searching for this predecessor of 36, so 30 will be the predecessor of this, so immediate smaller information. If I'm searching for the predecessor of this 10, so this 8 will be the predecessor. So by making a very small change in the given algorithm, this algorithm, you can make this converted to the predecessor algorithm. So rather than checking the right of this predecessor can be found on the left, rather than finding out the minimum, you find the maximum. And you find the maximum of left, not the right. And in the else part, if the left does not exist, then you have to move up and find it out. Then rather than checking it for the right, you check for the left. And your work is done. So just by changing the lefts to the rights and minimum to the maximum, the algorithm has been converted to predecessor. So both of these algorithms, the predecessor and the successors, will be very helpful for us in writing the deletion algorithms. So let's meet on the next term and we will see that how can we delete an element from the given binary system. Thank you for watching this video.